Hey YouTube, I'm back with another video. I would like to welcome my new subscribers and thank my original subscribers for watching my videos. Okay, today I'm here to talk about what is a hair journey in my opinion, because everyone else, they have their own opinion, but in general, it's basically the same thing. Obviously, a journey to health, but not only to health, but to find yourself. So, I'm going to start off by answering that question. In my opinion, a hair journey to me is a journey that you're going to get to know your hair and what your hair wants and how you know your hair will react to certain products and what not to put in your hair, what makes your hair healthy, soft, what makes it hard or break off. And when you get to know those things, common sense, you'll know what not to do in order to retain length and thickness and overall health of your hair. The next question, how to start a hair journey. You don't have to do this. You can just go ahead and go in it and get your products, your moisturizer products. But if you want to start on a clean slate where you don't have to worry about it down the road, back and cut off length that you retain and you feel like you're back at stage one, I suggest this, that you do this. I didn't, but I wish I did, but it's too late now. Start with a fresh trim. If you trim your ends, you'll get rid of the stringy ends that'll split up eventually. So when you do retain that length, I'm not saying it's always going to happen, but your hair might split up and keep splitting up. So by the time you do make it to a certain length, it'll look so thin and unhealthy that you just want to cut it. And by the time you get the cutting, you'll be back at stage one. And it'll give it a thicker and better appearance on top of that. And when it's unhealthy, it'll have a shorter, drier appearance. So just think about it. When you start one, just go ahead and get even a little trim. But I do advise to try to get all your ends cut off at once, even though it might, I'm not going to recommend it. But even if it, you have to in the lesion right here, you'll start off with a clean, healthier slate. And it'll look healthier than having those ends attached and you go along, that'll split up. Because if you just split off an inch, and you still have dead ends that you need to cut off, those are just gonna split up as well. So that's just something to think about. My third question is how to retain length and gain health and thickness. I'm gonna start off with saying thickness, some people is hereditary. A lot of people aren't gonna get hair as luscious and thick as others, but there is a way to prevent, you know, more hair thinning, unless it's really, really genetic. But some things can prevent the appearance of it. And like I said, to retain length, keep your hair moisturized and stay away from alcohol products that contain alcohol, petroleum jelly, mineral oil, because if you get a product with alcohol, alcohol will dry out your hair. And it will still, your hair will still be breaking and still appear dry. That's why sometimes people say, I put moisturizer on my hair, but my hair is still dry. It clicked, didn't it? Think about it. Petroleum jelly and mineral oil, they don't penetrate the hair shaft or the cuticle. They just stay on top of your hair. I'm trying to think of an example. Just notice how when you apply some grease to your hair, it'll just clog up the pores, or your hair just, it doesn't go into your hair cuticles. It'll just seem really greasy, and you can just tell the difference between petroleum free product and product with petroleum in it. When you find alcohol free and petroleum free product and mineral oil free product, you can tell the difference, because those free of products, they penetrate the hair and nourish your hair, and it'll feel smoother and softer and strong, even stronger, and it won't dry out the ends. And another way to retain length, this is a must for me. Every week, I do it twice a week, because that's what I put in my regimen, and it worked for me over a year, so I'm sticking to it. Deep conditioning with the moisturizing deep conditioner at least once a week. You can do it once a month, you can decondition once a month, but for me, I see better results when I do it once a week. because it puts that penetrates that moisture in your hair. It's, you know, replenishing your hair with moisture. And also with the protein, the difference between a moisturizer and a protein is moisturizer nourishes your hair and keeps it soft and smooth and not dry. A protein, it keeps it strong and sturdy and thick. And that's another thing, thickness. That's how you can gain thickness. But if you use too much of both, it can be bad. Too much moisture will leave your hair in a shower gushy, and if it does, and too elastic where it'll break off on its own. It doesn't even have to be dry to break off. Just know that your hair doesn't have to be dry to break off. You can have too much moisture overload, and if you ever do that, you have to go find some type of protein treatment. Try aphogee, 2-step protein treatment, and put that in. But we'll go over that in another video. But too much protein, of course, will make your hair dry, because your hair is protein already. It's keratin. And speaking of keratin, if you find products with keratin in it, that can help give your hair a thicker appearance, because it's itself, the hair is, you know, keratin, hair is made up of keratin, and it's restoring itself. So that'll be good for thickness. But if you put too much protein, it'll get hard and dry and brittle and break off, and you don't want that. That's what you just need it to make your hair stronger, because you've been putting moisture back to back in your hair, all these moisture products. You need something to balance it out, because it'll break off either way. And all these products will penetrate your hair for the better if you choose the right products. And I will go over the products that I use in another video, but I will put the products that I use down in the description bar, because it's too much to put in this video, because I don't want a long video, so I have to make another one. And oils, I must stress that no matter leave-ins and oils, no matter how much moisturizer you use on your hair, you need something to lock in and keep the moisture in your hair. Oils might be kind of heavy. Some oils are just dry and they just they do the same thing, they work the same way. Some just dry and non-messy, and some are messy. But either way, I use all the oils that I can that'll help my hair proceed and retain length and gain health. some of the oils that I use, like olive oil, coconut oil, which actually penetrates the hair. So when you moisturize your hair, it, you know, penetrates the particles in with it. Your hair, you know, goes into your cuticle, so your hair is getting moisturized. And after all of that, you can feel the smoothness of your hair. And I use leave-ins too, because they help reduce frizz. The oils do too, but it's like a little system. You wash your hair, leave-in, moisturize, and then seal with oil. You have to lock in all of that moisture, because hair needs all that attention, and it needs strength and moisture. Also, another I already said, if you want to thicken your hair, you can wash it with the keratin product. It's like the keratin shampoo, like I'll put it down in the description bar, but I apologize. But just any products that, if it's like a small keratin shampoo, then, you know, that has keratin in it, just use it and condition the whole system. It'll, you know, give it a thicker appearance. And last but not least, to keep your hair moisturized, you can, for you mixed girls, us natural girls too, and Caucasians, and even relaxed females, and males too, if you're watching, you can always use a cheek conditioner during the week. And if your hair gets curly, which that's, you're lucky, because you get the coat, you don't have to worry about restyling your hair in the same way. You can just get in the shower, cold wash your hair, meaning basically shampooing your hair with a conditioner. Not shampooing, but it's like lathering your hair with a conditioner instead of using shampoo. That locks in moisture and keeps your hair moisturized, because shampoo does dry out your hair. Some ethnicities are able to wash their hair shampoo without it drying out, because mixed races and Caucasian races, they have not, all races have natural oils from our scalp, but the she don't need my permission. Born in 1988, my new addition. Singing again,
Defend you to be continued. Maybe all I need is you and I'll be okay. There's something about your spirit that seems around the way.
Biotin, and it still dries out your skin when you're drinking water. It's because it's taking away the vitamin B5 that nourishes your skin. So if you can find a B5 vitamin and take that with your biotin, it should be okay.
What would it take to make you happy?
So this is all the details that I have, and I left
tell
one
me
out
what are you looking for exactly.
Open up your mouth and let nigga know. S-E-R-A-T.
Baby, what would you tell me, please? What I can do to make you smile again. Just say the word and baby, I will do whatever it takes for me to pray to your days. So baby, what do you say?
She told me what she wanted her to understand. She on the paper chasing me them rubber bands. Now I'm like, damn girl, you should see that toe. What you think I'm stacking these ones for? Get your ass on this dance floor and watch me make this cash flow. Cause bands to make her dance, bands to make her dance. All these chicks popping pussy, I'm just popping bands. Bands to make her dance, bands to make her dance. These chicks clapping and they ain't using hands.
That it takes is bending some cake. Then go on and take your clothes off. No need to make me wait. Girl, I can keep you dancing all night if you like. Cause you be working hard when everything I like. That's why I'm gonna get you right. Girl, I'm gonna get you right. Cause your body looks so nice. And you be telling me tonight I'm gonna dance for you. Baby, what can I do?
To understand, she know chasing me through rubber bands. Now I'm like, damn girl, you should see my toe. What you think I'm stacking these ones for? Show me some of this dance floor and watch me with this cash flow. Bands make her dance, bands make her dance. All these chicks popping pussy, I'm just popping bands. Bands make her dance, bands make her dance. These chicks popping.
Make her dance.